We are back in the Comanche. We are at Paraparaumu Airport, NZPP, on North Island, New Zealand, and we're heading for our first stop, South Wellington. Say goodbye to these people. Gotta take a good video. So 34, so this taxiway should take us there. Looking good. We are 27 miles away from Wellington. November, Zulu, Papa, Papa, traffic, Cessna, X-ray, Papa, Delta, Nissan base, runway 3. There's the guy. He's on base. What's he doing there? What's he doing? One, okay. We're turning this way anyway. He should be on base. He should be on the other end of the road, won't we? Beautiful day to head into Wellington, large airport and a pretty harbour. Well, the DME is showing me going further away, so. That's interesting. Okay, we haven't, my fault, we haven't, I haven't adjusted that gyro, so we get to take a look at the airport while I turn back. I didn't notice that. I thought something was wrong, because the DME. Which in fact means we were on the wrong way. We're actually flying into the wind, and that guy was landing. So it was entirely my mistake why that plane was there. That's a lesson that you definitely want to learn in the sim and not in real life. is Wellington town, city, and there's the runway here, I believe, 34, yep. So we are going to come round here and in here. There's a runway. I'm going to tune my VOR to 34, even though we can obviously see where it is. It's just a habit. My mouse is playing up. So we'll swing right in these rocks here and then come in this direction. Wellington. So our frame rates are now dropped, our frame rates to 20 FPS. Smooth enough. We're heading forwards. Pans will be a little bit jerky now. The airport is at 37 feet above sea level. So we will descend to 1,000 feet before leveling off for approach.
a bit high, but I think we'll just slow down here. Crosswind as well here, looking interesting. I've stopped while we're doing that. And there we are, that's where we're supposed to park. Before we can start the next leg. Our next leg takes us to Nelson, NZNS, a 71 mile westerly trip. It's Wellington International, New Zealand. Beautiful location. Now for the first time we put on the category one runway entrance. Not complaining, unless they reckon we suck so badly at takeoffs they're giving us the full runway. Some slow fouling on the plugs there. I put carbete on and made the mixture rich. If it hadn't worked, I would have obviously avoided takeoff. heading from the North Island fine into the South Island, so we're going across some water.
We're heading straight over to somewhere over here. What? Probably up behind the mountains over here. But to, while we're waiting for that VOI to come in, we'll tune back to Wellington's VOI, which on heading at 249 will take us in the right direction. So we don't get hopelessly off track. Let's see if we've popped over yet. Nope.
50 miles out, we should be able to see the, there's no reason we can't see the VOR already, unless it's right behind the hill, which it could be. We might climb a little bit more in a minute. The best climb rate in this plane is 95 knots. I'll have to check that. Sometimes you get a figure stuck in your head and it can be wrong. Try and check that DME in a, as soon as we've locked on to 9000. Trimmed it. I can look out the side window, but, well, landscape, not a huge amount of this altitude to see. And FSX won't render it in detail that far away either. Asking to trim down as we're speeding up. Let's go back into heading mode and check out. Have we got a signal yet? Come on. Nope. Hopefully the VO is down. We're now crossing over to South Island. We have finished North Island and now exploration of South begins. North Island is the most populated one, so we have lots of cities and lots of airports. South Island is the most famous for movies such as The Lord of the Rings, Middle Earth, where there are less airports, lots of mountains, and some fantastic scenery. So we'll be traveling further between airports, which makes it a little bit more fun, because just doing short hops is okay for takeoff and landings. But we would like to take off, climb and cruise a little bit and look at the scenery before having to land all the time. Well, I do anyway. Especially now we're going to New Zealand South, which is very beautiful. Take a peek outside the plane. It's going to be one of those relaxing cruises where if you can't sleep, you just put the video on late at night. And the droning and the scenery should send you off.
A bit of interesting views to this other. I have to turn the mouth this way to get it. There we go. There we go. Start us descent pretty well nowish. I'm glad it's not a bad conditions because we couldn't rely on the VOR. We still don't see the airport yet. It's going to be somewhere ahead. The airport is just over this mountain. So we aim for this gap and then do a circuit there. Last chance for this VOR. Nope. They probably changed it. Put some carbide on because we're almost sort of idle. Well, not idle, but we're descending. Engine's not been used so much. Don't need the carbs getting iced up. Just trying to see what's below us. Take a peek. And we don't need to overspeed, so. That looks like the airport, just there. Mass out of the way. I do love coming over, flying over a ridge to see what's on the other side of the ridge. It's so exciting. Even in a sim, because this is real terrain. Mesh. Okay, let's have a look now to the right as we come over this mountainside, ridge. Beautiful. I leap bank to the right, which should have a good view over here. Runway 3 was, runway 2, wasn't it? Runway 2, so let's set this to 2 now, as we're out of range. My VOR will let me do it. There's the runway, we see it. My mouse is really annoying me. Goes both directions. There we go. Runway. He wanted us to go wide traffic, so we're going wide traffic. Bang, bang. Take a peek at that. Going on the runway, there we are. Descent's coming out really, really nicely. Just have to make sure I don't bank into it this time like I did on my Wellington approach. We'll turn in over here. This building, I think, looks like a good reference point. Mass out of the way. Interesting winds. Let's keep the speed above 80.
Oh, come a bit high, but we had an updraft. Oh, we're keeping these people waiting. See that? Whoa. I think they're all worried about us landing. There's four of them waiting. That's cute. Four? Yeah, four, yeah. So. They'll get clearance to take off in a second. We can just park in the moment. Yeah, they can't. Yeah. No, we just park in. They can't move. Oh, I think I got a flat tire. Better get up, pop it up. You'll say exit my manual again in a minute. Or please exit. Did you hear my last transmission? I'm not supposed to go. Takeoff speed, flaps up. Lower FPS again. Well, we're coming straight in and taking bathroom brakes and then heading up again. So, where's that? Oh, here. Okay. There, pop a curb. Have a cup. We have now moved to the departure lounge, shed, alleyway. We're going to pick someone up. Yeah. Just my trim. Yeah, takeoff's going to have a little bit more trim up. All aboard. Well, with all the people in there, we'd be better to leave that open. Close it on takeoff. Nelson, there's a sign. So we might need a little bit more distance than the runway this time to take off. I don't think I've flown it with such a full load, before. We're not at capacity, but we're not far off it. There's no plane there. There's lots of birds. That's where we're heading over there. That's where the next one, my next airport is. It's not very long. Alright, buddy. Arms out the window, start flapping. I trimmed it nicely. I am happy with that. That was perfect. Because we're gonna climb is gonna be interesting. Like I said, I have a huge amount of power at our disposal here. About doing a merge. Emergency carb heat there. I'm currently heading back over the airport because I lost power, so if we don't get there back, I won't be coming in. Okay, we got power back. Same. the weight, we don't say, we've got enough power, it's sat smooth enough, we just haven't got much, the plane does feel heavy. Airport's over here. Okay, 3,000's good enough. Quite see the runway yet. Good, all I gotta do is see it now. See the buildings. See an airport. It's not a grass runway, but it's on, is it? Don't see a runway 2 yet. I see this runway. Maybe that's 2. Draw off some speed here. And then use this valley to follow in. This should bring us down to gear speed pretty soon. Speeds, and we're very high. So I'll follow this valley in. I think I did this before. Came in this way. Spinning around, I'll turn that. Wind on me doing that. Side slipping, yeah. That is me. Dramatic side slip in. That's the wind. Obviously, we're going to do a turn here. That's the wind again. I reckon we've been taken up by thermals, because normally a plane this heavy would have not much trouble descending. Okay, we're doing all right now. Coming in fast, but it's a fair long way. We're coming in a little very fast. Well, actually, we're okay now. But I'm going to be on the throttle because it's wind. On the runway. Of course. Got to skid round here because of the end of the runway. There's some. I landed on the runway and didn't skid off at the end and crash. And it was touch and go. More dramatic than expected, and on his ground handoff. Okay, we're over it. I guess, is there a taxiway or we just... just a deserted airport. I think I see a person. I do see a person. Whoever he or she is. Oh, two people now. I've obviously heard us come in. Okay, this seems to be a play area. I guess, oh no, it's not play, it's a bench, yeah. Okay, that's where our passengers will be. We'll turn around so we can see the tower. This is Motueka. Motueka, NZMK. Thank you for watching. Next stage will be in the Mustang, heading down to Christchurch.